Just we're feeling pretty good about ourselves. We had a good practice week this week. You know, we saw the tapes from last weekend's games and realized that they weren't as bad of games as some of us might have thought they might have been. But kept the heads high and keep the positive attitude and the manner. We have plenty of games left that can put us in a good position. So this is one of those weekends, and we're looking forward to tonight and tomorrow.
This is a lot of fun, though. I mean, here we are, three weekends left in the regular season, and we're right there for a chance at home ice.
Yeah, I mean, just to kind of have that itch to get out there and get after it, it's like playoffs already for us. So that's something that we're definitely going to try to ride the tide on and get off to a good start here tonight and then take care of things from there.
Are you finding the other guys, the other assistant captains and leaders in the room helping you step up in situations like this?
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, we got a good bunch of guys and the assistant captains and as well as the rest of the seniors. You know, we've been around for quite a bit, know what to expect. Except this is a little bit different team this year, and they're a little bit different team from last year. So, you know, you got to lace up the skates the same way and go out there and play. But, you know, with the leadership that we have in the locker room, it's pretty easy to get ready for the games.
You've had your share of injuries throughout your career, yet you're only 10 points away from 100 in a career. Is that at all in the back of your mind, or are you just focusing on what needs to be done winning-wise?
You know, to be honest with you, if it wouldn't have been put up on our athletic website the other day, I wouldn't even had a clue that I was in that position. That's something I can't worry about. Points and goals come and go. You know, they come in bunches or they don't come at all. So it's just something that I can't worry about. I got to go out and play my game. And then, you know, as long as, you know, I play my game and our team plays well and my line as well, you know, we chip in and stuff and do the things that we're supposed to do, we have a good chance at winning.
Do you like playing in this building, Brett?
Yeah, you know, I actually, because of those injuries and stuff that you mentioned earlier, this is only my second time here. So, you know, I missed those playoff ones. I missed everything from my junior and sophomore year when we played these guys. So I was here my freshman year, so it'll be kind of, it is obviously a very nice building, but we can't let that get to us either. We the ice sheet's the same size, and we're playing the game that we know how to play and can't worry about the rest of the crowd that the Sioux have.
Miloš Gordić back in the lineup. We asked Mel how important and how big of a factor Miloš can be here tonight.
Be huge, Turk. You know, we really missed him last weekend just because of the size of their defensemen and, you know, a lot of plays along the boards, down low behind the net, and that's where Miloš is really effective. So in tonight's game, he'll be effective because North Dakota has another big defense. You know, they're really strong along the wall, and that's where we're going to have to compete and play with them tonight to be successful.
We've struggled on scoring on the power play as of late. You were saying earlier in the week that this will be a huge weekend for the power play to start converting.
Anytime you're on the road, you know, and you get power play opportunities, you have to take advantage of it. And that's another area Miloš will be effective. You know, he's a big body in front of the net, takes away the goalie's eyes. But we have to be better than we were last weekend. I thought that was a good wake-up call for our power play because North Dakota will be just as aggressive, if not more. So we're going to have to outwork their PK guys and, like I said, take advantage of the power plays we get.
What's key to containing guys like Knight, Christo, and Nelson?
When you have the puck, you have to manage the puck when you're playing against their line. The best way to keep them in check is to force them to play in their zone. And, you know, we need some good shifts when they're on the ice and then playing in their zone and controlling the tempo there. When they do have it, is just make sure we have numbers back and take the time and space away. You're not going to completely shut them down, but you can do some things that, you know, sort of quiet them down.
You have to be very proud of the way the penalty kill has been performing, over 92% since the 1st of January.
Well, we've been much better there, and that's been, I think, a real key for us, and that's another factor on the road. Special teams is going to be huge on the road, and the penalty killers are doing a good job, and all starts with Josh Robinson in net. He's got to be your most effective penalty killer. He's done a good job, and then our defensemen have done a real nice job in front of him, too. So we've got to take less penalties. A lot of our key penalty killers are taking penalties right now, and they did against Nebraska-Omaha. So we have to stay on the ice and limit them on their power play opportunities.
Going back to our goaltending, how good will our goaltending need to be this weekend?
Solid. I don't think anything, you know, spectacular or any more or less than it has been to this point in the year. You know, we're just going to, like I said, it's more of a team concept. We have to limit them on their odd-numbered rushes. And then Josh is probably going to have to make us a couple key saves here and there, and he's done that before. So he's just got to play his game, and he's very capable.
This is a tough building to play in, but it's a fun building to play in. Is it very important for us to try to take the crowd out of this game?
No question. You know, we're not here to put on a show. We're here to shut their team down and, you know, sort of quiet the crowd down. And if you check the other team, you can do that. And, yeah, no question about it. It's a great environment to play in. As a player, these are the type of environments you want. You know, there's going to be a packed house, 11,000 people, and they're all cheering against you. So what more could you want?